Vsauce, Kevin here. Imagine that a guy transporting thousands of birds in an enclosed truck stopped before crossing an old, dangerous bridge. His avian cargo makes the truck too heavy to safely cross. So how could he make it lighter? The birds. What if he banged on the side of the truck, scared the birds inside, and caused them to fly around? If they're in the air, they'll weigh nothing, and he can safely cross the bridge. Right? The scared, angry birds are flying inside his truck as he slowly drives over the bridge. Here we go. Uh-oh. Don't worry. I'm sure the truck driver and the birds are fine. The bridge not doing quite as well. Why didn't his plan work? Because he didn't account for the unseen physics of bird flight. Excuse me, bridge. To fly, a bird has to generate enough lift and thrust to counteract drag and its body weight. We can calculate that by making weight W, which equals 0.3. A constant value related to the angle of attack, which is the angle of its wings relative to the air, usually 6 degrees or so, multiplied by the airspeed V times the mass flow of air, which is airspeed V times air density D, multiplied by S, which is the surface area of their wing and... You know what? Look, calculations aside, I like to think of this riddle as thousands of uncaged birds just freaking out and flapping their wings inside this truck. Some birds are generating a downward force on the air to create the thrust and lift that gets them up off the truck bed. Some are flying horizontally, and they're using thrust and lift to stay in the air, and others get in the air and free fall, which reduces the overall load in the truck by their full bird weight. The important part is that even though the truck driver can't see it, air is a fluid, and these birds are throwing physical forces around in every direction as they move within that fluid. Since he's got thousands of birds in a closed truck, those forces are going to balance out so that the truck's weight is basically the same with the birds flying around as it was with them just sitting there. It's easy to understand his logic, though. Thousands of birds are heavy. Get them up in the air, and they won't be. But seeing the unseen, like the forces of flight, requires a high degree of abstract thinking. And that's a pretty new concept. Not like last year new, but like 50,000 years ago new, when Homo sapiens separated itself from other hominins by entering the era of behavioral modernity. Abstract thinking is really hard to do. We're thousands of years past the Stone Age, and we still encounter everyday paradoxes because we often miss what we can't see. The truck driver's eyes couldn't show him all the complexities of bird flight physics. I can't see time! That's not a weird thing to admit, because nobody can. Sure, we can look at a clock or notice the effects of time on things like the changing of seasons, but we can't actually see the dimension of time. We see representations of time, and even those can be deceiving. Here's an example. You hate your evil identical twin. You want him out of your life, at least for a little while, so you put him on a ship to the nearest planetary system while you stay on Earth. My evil identical twin is named Bevan. That's short for bad, Kevin. Bevan. Alpha Centauri is about 4.4 light years away. If I put Bevan on a ship called V-Space 2 and sent him off at, say, 0.8C, that's 80% of the speed of light, he'll get to Alpha Centauri in 5.5 years. If Bevan plants a flag and then flies back, he would return in 11 years. For me. 11 Kevin years. Distance and also time seems to work differently for Bevan. From his point of view, traveling at 0.8 times the speed of light makes Bevan's distance contract to just 2.64 light years, which means it takes him just 3.3 years each way. To Bevan, his trip only took 6.6 years. My 11 years of freedom from Bevan were only 6.6 years of banishment to him, which means my identical twin is now 4.4 years younger than me. That unseen element of time just wasn't the same for us. Since we can't actually travel at luminal speeds yet, we have to explore special relativity in the lab and in our minds. And sometimes that's a good thing because seeing can deceive us. It's why I burnt my burger. The higher the heat, the better, right? I could see the outside of the burger cooking fast in the pan, but that char is actually making heat conductivity to the center happen less smoothly. Instead of engaging the Maillard reaction that combines sugars and amino acids to bring out the flavors, higher heat just scorches the outside without cooking the center evenly. It tastes bad and the inside is still pretty raw. We can get food poisoning because our eyes aren't very good at thermodynamics. But what if you're the hamburger and you want to stay uncooked? Metal. Even though metal conducts heat to cook things like burgers, metal also protects against unseen heat. Thermal energy that comes in the form of infrared radiation exists just below red on the visible spectrum of light. And infusing protective gear with reflective metal repels infrared radiation. Like this aluminized emergency blanket, which reflects about 95% of radiated heat. NASA invented metallized polyethylene TEREPHTHALATE for space, but I use it to look nice. When it comes to birds in a truck, evil twins traveling the cosmos, or cooking burgers, what you see is not always what you get. Here, I'll draw two straight lines. There. Now, just count the lines. One. Two. Three. Even what appears to be the simplest visible truth can be filled with complexity that we can only see when we admit that we can. And as always, thanks for watching.